going on, everybody? CJ John coming at you here. Today we're going to be doing one of those cool videos, install videos, whatever you want to call it, that everyone seems to enjoy. So we're just going to jump right into it. Alright, so the goal for today is to clear out some space for the lithium. I got my two banks sitting in the garage behind me. They're already topped off, ready to go, so I'm going to be building the box for them today and getting them installed. So I got to find a new spot to put this. I'm thinking we're going to take out the Walmart battery here and remove all this junk and move her over here, and then get our cables run over to the lithium and clear out all that shit. So let's go ahead and do that then. It seems like a pretty solid plan for now. Alright guys, so first things first here, we're gonna go ahead and take off our wing nuts, but I got them wrenched down pretty tight, so we're gonna pry them off. Disconnect the battery here. I fuck with boss bitches, only like them cash dogs. I fuck this little bitch, think she don't want, she don't want. But I know I can't be the only one. Tell them niggas that they got the one. They got the one. They treat you better when you're number one. Oh, by the way, for those of you that have heard the car before, like with the doors and everything, at the past, like, I think two or three meets that I went to, a lot of people said it sounded great. You know, the all around clarity of everything was amazing. Well, I figured out a friggin' secret that I didn't know. That when you have a friggin' 4-channel bridge, do you still need all 4 channels of the RCAs? I'm like, what the fuck? So I just came across it on Google one day. I was like, I'm bored, and I was just looking stuff up. It was a home theater system. And I noticed that they had Y-splitters going into all 4 channels, even though they were only using 2 channels. So I was like, huh. So I asked a couple people, and they're like, yeah, you need a... So well, shit. I did not know that. So I fucking plugged 2 more channels in with a Y splitter, and boom, the fucking tweeters come to life instantly, too. Like, it was a crazy noticeable difference. So today, after I get the lithiums in, I'm gonna have to go through and retune all my amps again, because these things are fucking loud now. So I don't know. I don't even know if I'll need a C2 on the tweeters now. It really depends how it comes out when I put the second C2 on the mids. So, if I can make up some space when I get the lithium in here, I might throw the other C2 in. Never know. So, we'll see how that goes. Alright, now we gotta remove our little holders here that aren't very tight other than this 2x4. Just being held in with a couple screws. So, let me go grab the drill and get on that. Alright guys, so we got the drill here, we're gonna start taking out these screws. Those little blocks are actually really helpful that we made a long time ago. I used them on my previous battery banks, I believe. I'm really excited for the lithiums. I was watching the way that they were charging and discharging and everything and trying to rest. Oh my god, it's freaking amazing, the voltage. I think they're resting at 13.5 right now, so that's exciting. I need to go get a longer bit to take out the 2x4, that sucker goes pretty far in there. So I'm gonna go swap out my bit and get that one out. All right, so we got a longer bit here, and we're gonna get her out. All right, so now we got tons of space over here to mount that amp. And we're gonna, the battery box is gonna go, it's gonna come up a little bit, about an inch away from this, because I have a lot of cables running back here, and especially these So I got to give about an inch of space back here to run my cables behind and make it all clean. Even though, you know, people aren't going to see it, I still like it clean and managed. So when I ever need to work on it, I know exactly where everything's going. So we're going to go ahead and clean all that up too and get everything completely out of the way. And we might even hook up some of the other runs too that we have just tucked up, and I don't even know where the fucking grounds are. My positives are right here, and the grounds look like they fell back here. I feel one. Oh, here's the other one. So, alright, well, let's get to disconnect the maps then and start moving around and flip flopping. Alright, so now we got Allen wrenches here. We're gonna go ahead and remove our positive and negative off of C2. Put those back in later. For those of you guys that, if anyone has noticed a difference in the quality from the intro of the video to when I started, taking stuff out, let me know, because in the intro I was shooting on 4K, and I dropped it to 1080, because 4K, one, it takes up a lot of space, and two, it's, on a timer, because, I guess they don't want you using up all your space on your phone or whatever. So, and your phone starts getting hot and shit. So, let me know about that. I've always been curious. I never truly noticed a difference, but we got a ground here. It's extremely friggin' long, but then our positive is like triple the length. This is, came off the end of my spool. So, I didn't want to go and cut it because I can always use it as a different length later. Cut us a shorter one, so I just didn't want to go wasting wire. I only have two full spools left, so that's supposed to get this whole freaking back completed. Alright, so now that we got those out, we're gonna go ahead and remove our remote wire, which I believe is a 2.5 millimeter. Let's see if I'm right. Yes, it is. And same thing for the speaker wires here, which I would like to flip this amp around and try to get the speaker wires on this side so it's a little bit shorter, because I hate that, especially with how hot these amps get. Kind of scares me sometimes, but I guess it's no different than the temperature sensor wires land right on the fucking hottest part, because these amps get like, the highest I measured this one was like 140 degrees. So if it hasn't melted anything yet, I don't think it's gonna melt anything anytime soon. So as long as I keep the temperature maintained, but see, sometimes I'm not paying attention to the temperature. I'll just be jamming for, you know, on a trip heading to a meet or coming home from a meet, or just, you know, daily driving, and I'm not paying attention. I'm just straight playing some jams, and next thing you know, I look down, and all of a sudden I see the freaking temperature gauge at, you know, 55 Celsius, or the highest I've seen it was 59, and I was like, shit. So I literally turned it down for about 5 minutes, and it dropped to like 56. So I just kept it low for a little bit, and I was almost home already, so I was like, you know, I'll push it to the rest of the way. So, and I swapped this plate around when I did this, because notice the model number of the amp, well, the model of the amp is on the input, well, the output side on the 800. So it was on this side too, but when I had the amp going this way because the battery was here, I flipped it around. So we're gonna go ahead and flip that around too. Might as well do it now and get it over with, because we're gonna be flipping the amp back around. So, 2.5 millimeter. I really like this design on the top plate, way better than pretty much every other amp, like that, the 5500s, any, pretty, like I said, any other amp. because all you need to do is take out these four screws. Now, I don't know if a lot of you know this or not. If you were ever curious on how to take off the top plate on, say, your 55s, 35s, any of those amps, you have to completely take off the whole side plate on either side where all of your writing, your inputs, and all that shit are. And you have to unbolt all these, and it comes off, and then your top plate slides out. So, like when I did my 5500 and had to silence it, that was a pain in the ass. So, turn that around. And in case you're wondering how people customize their amps and put carbon fiber or paint them and all that crap, that's how they do it. Just take your top plate off. Go ahead and do that so they don't have to sit there and tape up their amp and possibly get it on the black. Because you can always replace the top plate. You know, there's no doubt about that. So, it's always best to remove it if you ever want to customize it. Oops. Sorry, guys. Alright, so, bolts back in. Anytime I ever bolt something down that has a more than one bolt, I always do sort of like a mechanic style, like how I would do my fucking lug nuts on my wheels. I always do a crisscross pattern, and once I get them all snug, I go through one more time and torque them down. But with this here, it's kind of gentle, so I'm not really going to torque them down at all. I'm just going to snug them up. So this one here is done. Gonna go ahead and take this one out. Oh, I always forget how heavy these things are for mids and highs. Put her over there. Now, time for the little guy. We're gonna remove all of our RCAs. Oh, shit. I order more Y splitters that actually match because I hate not matching wires. Just like my not matching RCAs really irritate me too. But I just gotta keep thinking to myself, it's only temporary, so don't get ahead of yourself. I finally got my outputs to work. The Y splitters again, if anyone has ever had this problem with their outputs not working on their amps on a 4-channel, well, channels 1 and 3 are your left, and 2 and 4 are your right. So I was having issues. I had 1 and 3 plugged in, and the right side of my mids would not kick on. And just last night, I figured out that, and kind of felt like a dumbass, which I am, but I never really thought about it. That's just kind of, I never used the outputs on my Symphony amp, except for a long, 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 long time ago. And you guys remember the PSI build when I had the 2K. It was just this and the 2K. And that was the only time I ever used the inputs, and being that the 2K only takes in the left channel, I didn't really think about it, so. But you learn, and now I know. So, and now you guys know if you didn't know. Negative. You know what? We're gonna leave those in. I don't feel like screwing with them. They don't have the reducers on the end. So I'm not gonna sit there and try to fight with them to get them back in. We're moving this one first, anyways. We're gonna go ahead and leave our speaker wire in too. I just want to move everything else out of our way. I gotta get our boat wire out of the way. And there we go. This stuff. So we're gonna try to put it as close as we can over here. I don't know what side we're gonna put where yet. I think we're gonna put the speaker wires up front with the power wires because I only have so much length. We're gonna have our RCAs and then follow our knob front to the back. I'm gonna have it scoot up a little bit so I can adjust it, because again, I do need to tune it later. So go ahead and take her out. Rolling on with the wood, ready to hunt some. Yeah.
smash him. All right. Nigga, strike his ball, so. You don't want none.
I don't need nobody. Running short on speaker wire. Alright, this is an issue. So, I think I have Slack under here. Oh, I already pulled it all through. Oh no, there is Slack. A little bit. I think we're gonna see, we gotta have a certain amount of clearance. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna measure the battery width. I know it's about 9.5 inches, because that's what we're gonna go by for space, and give it an inch, so we'll call it 10.5. So, right where this hole is right here is where the batteries are gonna come out to. Yeah, we're gonna need a lot more clearance than that. So I'm thinking this way, we're gonna take the C2, slide it over, put this on that side, and we'll go ahead and try that one. Holy shit! A bird just freaking flew right into the side of the garage. Or landed on it and freaking... Oh my god, that was loud. Now he's up there jumping around. Anyways, so let's try that instead and see how that goes. We have plenty of power wires, so... and RCA. We have too much RCA back here. I literally have it rolled up in like an extra freaking 8 foot back here. So these are 17 foot RCAs. My car's only 15 foot long overall. That's from bumper to bumper. So you're going from console to the back here. It's only about not even 10 foot. When you want to consider all the turns and bends and tight runs, then you can consider an extra 2 foot in there or so, but... So, let's get our power wires out of here. Yeah, that's like a perfect length of power wire. I think that's still adjustable to where I can get to it. I'm still open to where I can get to it. Let's go ahead and clear this out and measure again. And make sure that we clear.
Okay.
So, 10.5 we're giving it. Again, that's to that hole right there. And they are 26 wide. So, let's see. We're going to do the math here. We got 39.5. Actually, no, we got 37.5. Because we got to consider the panel. So, 37.5 divided by 2. Let's do the math here. Pull out my calculator because it's too early in the morning. So, 37.5 divided by 2. That's 18.75 is our center. So, 18.75. And so we got 18.75 and then 26. So it's 13 needs to be on the 18.75. So we're going to go ahead and measure that out. I'm going to go grab a pencil and get that mark. And then I'm going to the edge here, but I'm on my panel, and my panel's half inch, so we got to consider a half inch on top of that, too. So that's going to be 19.25, which is right here. You a savage now, savage now. So then 13 has to go there. So 13 comes to here. And 13 comes to here. So we are going to be a little bit off on that. So, I'm probably going to have to end up angling this amp to fit it in here. Well, actually, I built an amp rack, a temporary amp rack for my C2. So, I can even throw this under the C2. I have plenty of space. We'll see how that goes.
Alright, so we got our temporary amp rack here that I made, so don't mind it. Looks like shit. Once I put the amp on it, it won't look like shit. So, I'm gonna wanna scoot it back as far as possible. Not that far. That should be pretty good right there. And I can still get to everything, so I think we're gonna go ahead and do that, save us some space, but we won't have any room for the second C2 then, which I'm perfectly fine with. I don't need to draw any more power than I already am. So I think we're gonna do that. So I'm gonna mount this right in here, center it out, make it look all pretty. And I might even throw an LED strip under here, who knows. Alright guys, so we're gonna put in our temporary amp rack here. We got the L brackets ready to go, just to screw down, just to get it so it doesn't move. Got all of our wires ran and ready to go, so let's fit it all in here, hopefully. That barely reaches. So, I'm gonna center it right about there. Don't mind this amp rack, it looks like absolute garbage until you go and put the amp on it, then it doesn't look too bad. So we got that in there, and we're gonna go ahead and pack her down. Screw here. Gonna put in two, just so it doesn't slide. It's got pretty decent weight to it, so. And when you put that big old C2 on there, I doubt it's gonna move, so. Oh yeah, that's solid. That's mint. Now, we're gonna go ahead and, I guess, put the C2 on. We have nothing to really do. Oh, I'm gonna throw an LED strip in there. Who cares? Fucking make it look cool. So, I'm probably gonna put this right here. And just tape it down with something, or maybe even put it under it. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab something to tape this down with and get on with that. Alright, so everything's all set. We got our LED strip in, and we're gonna start mounting the fucking C2 on here and hopefully get some tune playing. Center it up. See, now that doesn't look too bad. I just kinda did a quick spray on it, make it black. And it doesn't look bad. I think when you get the LEDs on there, it'll look pretty good. I got enough room to get in here and work. So, as long as this reaches, which it does, barely, we're good to go. So, let's go ahead and pop a couple screws in. I'm only going to put two again because I'm just kind of holding it in place. Look at that. Temporary. That's solid. This is probably the best temporary amp rack I have ever built, I think. Because all the other ones I ever built were like just a piece of wood. That's not bad. So now we gotta connect all of our wires in and do all that shit. So got this one going in, a remote wire coming off of our 800. That one going in. And then after I get this tuned up later, I'll be sure to take you guys with me. And once I get it all tuned up, I'll probably make another video and let you guys hear it on the C2 like I promised. For those of you that didn't get to go out to the meet and hear it or whatever. So, for those of you that live out of state. Let's see. Alright, so we got these labeled here. Right mids, so that's gonna go into channel 2, which is negative on the far side, on the side. Right down. Alright, so now all we have left is to disconnect our RCAs out of here, going into here, and our power wires, and we're good to go. So we got our RCA connectors here. I'll tidy these up at a later time. Here's our output, nice and available for us. That plugged in, nice and tight, going out through here. Wire management is my best friend. Going into the input on this side, and I'll probably tidy this up with a zip tie later. Just tuck it up under here. But that's that. Last but not least, power wires. We use the same ones that we had. The extremely ridiculously unnecessary long ones. Got our sky high reducers on them. Negative is on the outside. Snug it down. Three times as long power wire that can go up to the front of the freaking car if we wanted it to. There we go. Oh, and I almost forgot. Temperature sensor. Always nice to be safe. So I don't fry an amp. Can I just hook this up somewhere? I want it on the input side, so I'm probably gonna run it around. I just have it sitting here and just tuck it up in here. So when I actually have the car built, I actually have my temperature sensor inside the amp, so can't really see it. In my past build, you were not able to see any of it. I don't even really know where I had it ran to, honestly. I just remember it was inside the amp somewhere, behind the back plate. So there we go. All right, so last thing we gotta do now is just build a battery rack and get the batteries in and connect everything and then tune them. So that's all I got for now. I'll catch up with you guys in a little bit when we get that all done and installed. All right, guys, so got the lithiums in, all wired up. Got our jumpers here. I'm gonna shorten those up at a later time. Just put them in there for now, just get the car started and some music going. Got the C2 all polished up. Everything's all ran and good to go. I got the 800 down there. There's a temporary amp rack. And I said I was gonna put in some LEDs, and so I did. Whatever. Had to look cool somehow, but anyways. Got it all tuned up already. So, gonna might as well just go ahead and play.
Oh shit, man, y'all niggas keep dropping all this bullshit, man. Rapid ass F-15 on Pack lock with a beam on Glock with a beam. Every nigga in my team on Oh, you a tester, you a savage, and I'm a savage now. You never spray a hang around this ass nigga. Last nigga tryna come down. Swear to fucking God, left his body in a lost and found. Left him in the mud. Don't say shit, bitch. Yeah, nigga, fuck, nigga. Who the fuck, 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 fuck. Let me introduce y'all to something new, Cooking up doubles and bitches, all my nigga killing bitches. pull up on you with the fittest, nigga, we gon' have a baby. I'm bringing numbers and bitches, all my nigga carrot business. Pull up on you with the fittest, nigga, we gon' have a baby. Cooking up doubles and bitches, all my nigga carrot business. Pull up on you with the fittest, nigga, we gon' have a baby. I know a lot of niggas that ain't saying nothing real to you. I said my soul about the rich.
Alright, so as you guys can see, the lithiums are fucking hold up amazing right now. I only have one run connected. My other two are still tucked in back here. I never got around to that. Still got to get the front finish before you can connect those. So that's just on one run. Car's idle right now. I have my external regulator set to 14.6, and the lowest we dropped to is 14.4, and that was just like a quick, like, second, so I would say it's pretty damn good. Got about a total of almost 3,000 watts running all in all right now, so that's not too bad. We still got another C2 to throw on, and after I tune them up and fix the tweeters a little bit, they sound amazing right now. So, for all those people that heard it at the past meet and everything, with less voltage, you know, that shit battery, and not tuned very well, be sure to catch me at the next show, meet, whatever, and take another listen, and let me know if you hear a difference. But, if you guys enjoy videos like this one, let me know, leave it in the comments below, and I will be more than happy to make more. It's been a long time since I made a video like this, so, hope you guys enjoy, and I'll catch you guys next time.
I was chopping loud, off the vacant house. My nigga how, you tryna take my style. All my niggas wild, they take you out. Boy, you tryna be like Hefe, that's gonna take a while. I spark up that loud, I can't hear a sound. Count 100,000, I'm like fuck a trout. Chopper on the couch, that bitch gon' bow.